Hey Jacob, back with another matchup video. This video I'm going to be doing one of the requested videos, which was Bison against the Urien matchup. Bison against Urien matchup. So I have pretty good experience actually against Urien players with Bison, and I feel like it's kind of 5-5. Mainly you have to have basically good strategies against Urien, because Urien players kind of, well, Urien's play very aggressive and you basically have to stay patient during the matchup. So I'm gonna be going over how the matchup works: long range, mid range, and then close range. So first I'm gonna go over that Urien has very good zoning capability. He has good fireballs. His headbutt can be used as an anti if you try to jump over, you know, full screen. He has armor, which helps him a lot. If you try to jump in on him, he can do headbutt on you. But there are ways to get around it. Do one of my setups that I usually do. I usually absorb one, those versus the other one. And once I see him charging, I basically just do that. So I use the beast skill to absorb the light. Those reverse over, and once I see him charge, I just throw it at him. If you can see him charge early enough, you obviously can just hit him. So you see him charging early enough, then you can get in on him. Alright. So that's a pretty good tactic to use. Those reverse over. You can just keep doing that. But you don't want to do it there, because he can obviously dash up. Me trying to store it. Alright, this is more like the basic Urien stuff, you know. You're punishing the overhead, I mean the headbutt. So you always want to stay kind of like grounded. You don't always want to stay crouched against some of Urien's options, because he does have an overhead. So it can be very tough to deal with. Let's say if he's doing like something like that. Now, let me use medium. Okay, it doesn't reach. Oh, that's strange. So if I... let's do something like that, okay. Yep, wrong one. Okay, yeah, he is too far when he does that. Alright. I mean, you can do certain things. You can counter it, though. Like, if you expect the Urien to do headbutt after, like, basically he's committing to the combo. You can kind of react to it. And expect to come in and punish. Get a lot off of it. If it's always something that you have to see coming, basically. Yeah, most of the time is you being able to react to it or read it. Yeah, most of the time you're trying to. Urien's basically putting you in a reaction game, like basically testing your reactions with random headbutts. A lot of Urien's, they would just rush in on you with headbutts, shoulders. Heavy shoulder is punchable. Basically, the basically, if he hits you on the edge of his shoulder, or like the end of his shoulder, like when he's starting his shoulder, you know, at the end, the last frames of the shoulder, if he hits you on the tip, depends on how safe he is. He's never going to be plus if he does it, hits you on the tip. He's only zero with his EX. That's the most he can get. He's always going to be negative. But depending on how... like when he hits you, like basically if he hits you really close to when it starts up, like that was the heavy one. So if you block it very up close, he's very punishable. Like I don't know how punishable, but he's really punishable. Alright, so he's light punishable. Alright. Probably like -5. Alright. So, but if he hits you pretty close to like the edge of it, then he's a little different. Or if he just completely whiffs it in front of you, like that happened to me too. I would sometimes just do the same thing and just press that. See, if he hits at the edge, he's safe. So that he's safe, but he's not, you know, it's your turn to hit him. But if he has EX, he can easily just reversal you. That's only if you can. You do want to check Urians as well. Don't be afraid to depress buttons on them when they're minus. But if you see that a Urien is reversal, you know, doing the EX headbutt, then that means he's not afraid to, you know, do stuff like that. Most Urien plays, you don't really need to be afraid. Don't be afraid to just throw those headbutts in, because the heavy headbutt, you are safe. And if you could trust, you know, yourself that it's okay, you could block some of the setups. You know, you want to be close in on certain characters like Bison. You know, you could be close with Bison, but he does have a 3-frame. So you do have to be careful as well. That does change a lot, that he has a 3-frame. If he didn't, then most of the stuff, basically, Bison will be in trouble against Urien. So his EX shoulder, for example, that's something that he would have to be careful with. Alright, that's another thing I want to explain. So if a Urien, you don't want to use Devil's Reverse after he's done with this, because he can easily react and or wait after you use it and just EX headbutt you. Obviously, if you see it coming, then you could punish it. Now, if you see him charging up, you can like hurry up and get to him. But once he's done, you don't want to do anything, because then he could just wait there and just wait for you to come down and EX reversal or EX headbutt to knock you out of the air. Yep. Or you could do armor if you're doing the regular Devil's Reverse. So yeah. So you don't want to jump in on Urien late. And most of the time you don't. You shouldn't be doing that too close anyways. Yeah. Most Urians don't try to do something like that too close. Alright. So. Hold on. Which one was this? Okay, yeah, that's what I wanted to show. Okay, so you don't have to be worried about his EX shoulder. If he does attempt to press a button, then you could just press that. That beats out anything after his EX shoulder. You can't do anything unless if he presses his EX reversal. So you do gotta be aware when a Urien is desperate. You know, he's low on health. He has to get on you fast. So you do have to watch out for that. It's not a problem eating that, because he doesn't really get too much off of that, besides like doing a jab or something. Because at that moment, he's wondering if you're going to press a button or not. So he might go for the EX headbutt. So it's just knowing when, you know, Urien's going to take that risk. Especially when you're doing like block strings as well. Especially when you're doing block strings. Like sometimes I would do a block string. Urien's would reversal at very different times than you expect. They won't just always do it on wake up. Some Urien's would do it like during block strings mainly. And I'll do a block string and go for it. And most of the time when I reversal Urien, they do it at like a long distance most of the time. Since it kind of has like a forward leap, it's pretty like deep. It can hit you pretty far. If you like pressing a button, you know, it can hit you pretty far basically. It's not like a DP where it's very vertical. You know, this is horizontal DP, so it can hit you from quite a distance if you stick out a button. You know, if you press that, it'll still hit you. Even like from max distance, which is kind of annoying, but yeah, it happens. So you catch a Urien pressing button. It doesn't matter from max range or not. You're going to use the same punish, which is the axe after the crush counter. You know, that's his only punish basically. You won't reach in time to do the crouching fierce if you have the trigger. See, the crouching fierce will work like before you're able to like if he does it close, obviously you can use the crouching fierce into B trigger. But if he doesn't, then oh no, if he hits you from a you know, too far basically, then you have to use the other one, the Psycho Axe, into V trigger. It has pretty fast recovery too. That's another thing I don't like about it. That you have to make sure that you press it fast enough basically. Once he does it, you have to react very fast. Like I said, you have to play very fast against Urien. Wait, is he safe really? Hold on, so if he attempts to... Okay. Yep. that was kind of weird, but basically punish him in time. Yeah, you have to have a very fast crush counter on him. Yeah, it kind of sucks. But yeah. So yeah, you can still pressure Urien. You can't really do anything. You have a 3-frame. So after this, if he doesn't decide to reversal, you know, you can still pressure him. That's only if, you know, don't be afraid to pressure, obviously. You want to still keep that pressure going against Urien, because he can't really do anything about it. I think he has 4-frame, not sure if he has 3-frame. Pretty sure he has a 4-frame only. Yeah, positive, yeah. I'm not certain, but I can check, I can test it out. Let's try this real quick. Alright. One more just in case. That too fast. If it doesn't say reversal, sometimes it doesn't read it, so you have to do it again. Yeah, this is pretty weird. I have to do it the other way. Alright. Oh, I did that one. Oh. My bad, I'm just trying to test this out. Be patient with me. Alright, I'm gonna mash. If you wanna make sure you get stuff out when you're playing in a match, just mash. Gotta make sure you're getting that punish out. Close game. It's okay to mash the button. It's not a bad thing. Alright. Okay, yeah, he has 4-frame. So he always had to hold that against Bison. Yeah. I just forget sometimes about the frames. But I usually just go by feel. Once I see Urien getting counter hit, I have a good idea that he can't do anything about it. So yeah, mainly pressure Urien is pretty heavily, like in the beginning. Then when I start seeing that their health is low, and they really need to get things, you know, the ball rolling, they're gonna start, you know, taking risks. You know, with the shoulder into V trigger, the forward medium punch into the target combo overhead into V trigger. At that point, as a Bison player, you have to be very, very good at blocking. That's another thing. Bison doesn't have any reversal. He has V reversal. That's a good option to use if you get put in an X reflector. No problem, basically. You can get out of there with that. He can grab you out of your V reversal, so you do have to be careful. But it's not bad to V reversal to get out of that. Basically, the mix-up. The multiple 50-50 mix-up that he puts. Alright, so Bison doesn't really have any tech for the Aegis Reflector like I have with Birdie. Like, at least Birdie, you know, you could go through the Aegis Reflector with Chain. I haven't really found anything with Bison. I mean, you could Devil's Reverse, EX Devil's Reverse over it if he's like charging behind it. But most of the time you want to stay like patient, like I said, you always want to stay patient. You always want to stay patient in a lot of situations against Urien. You want to make him make the mistake. Then you want to, you know, you basically have to keep your reactions on point and make sure you punish him for trying anything out, basically. Yeah. I do find a lot of Urien's trying to jump in on me when I use Bison, because they know that Bison has a pretty bad anti-air. So make sure you keep your like anti-airs on point as well. I face a lot of Urien's that try to jump in on me a lot. Now most of the time I don't have to block it, cause sometimes I'm not expecting the jump in. So sometimes I'll block and just like, you know, deal with the defense there. And then after that I have to, you know, basically watch my air, you know, watch the air, basically watch, make sure I stay with the solid anti-air. You know, jump back jab is very good. I mean, jump back short you could use as well, but since jump back jab has like more of like a air to air option, because jump short is more like a like you're doing on someone's wake up and you're trying to like, you know, it's a close match, you're against it, you know, it depends basically when you're gonna use this. I'll explain that in a different matchup. That's mainly made against Zangief players, but I'll explain that in the Zangief matchup with Bison. Okay, so you basically want to keep Urien pressured. Once you have him in the corner, he's very he struggles a lot. Obviously any character will struggle in the corner, but he does have reversal. The thing I don't like about Urien is that you can't bait out the if you jump bait out the reversal, he still will be safe, which kind of doesn't make any sense. Like if I throw Urien and I bait out the reversal, I can't do anything. If I jump bait it, I have to block it. Can't backdash. Yeah, basically you have to yeah, can't use like those first. And then something weird will happen, yeah. So you can't jump bait his EX reversal with Bison. Wait a second, hold on. I just did it there. So there's something about timing. Wait, because yeah. So you have to do it early enough basically, so if you really got a Urien committing into it. But if you do it like really late, like you get it like very good, basically you like basically when he's about to wake up, he can block. He can block in time. I faced a Urien that was able to block. Whenever I did get the cross up, he's able to recover in time to block. See? That's how I do it early enough. You have to basically do it early enough, but sometimes it's very ambiguous. It's a different outcome every time, depending on how early you jump in or not. Alright, let me go back to the neutral game. I explained that well, okay. So, in the neutral game, you want to make sure that... Okay, what's going on? Oh. In the neutral game, mainly, Urien does have good buttons as well. His medium kick... it's pretty good against Bison to try to like, if you see a Bison trying to go for this, you can stick out medium kick to kind of like interrupt him. But if a Bison is really spacing this out well, then you kind of gotta like stay defensive there. You know, your medium kick, crouching medium kick beats Bison's crouching medium kick. It's longer. Urien's heavy punch is not that useful against Bison, unless if you're using on wake up, obviously. I mean, you know that Bison does have a wake up, so unless if you face a Bison that's waking up short a lot, you know, 3-frame. But you won't really run into that too much. It's mainly during block streams that Bison will just check you with this, but not on wake up too much. Yeah, doesn't want to take the risk. Most of the time, you do want to use his standing heavy kick, because you're planning on basically meeting the Bison, so you might as well just use the standing heavy kick. It is plus on block, so it's very good to use on Bison on wake up. Bison, he could reversal it. He could reversal a chop as well, so it's basically the Bison's choice if he wants to get Urien off of him. Yeah. And the EX knee is pretty good against Bison because Bison can't not anti-air that. The only time you can anti the knee, if you really see it coming, you can anti it. Most of the time, you have to kind of like block it and deal with the 50-50 mix-up if he has meter. Because it's the same situation with the headbutt almost. It's not punishable, only in very like situations where he hits you really high and like the top of your head. It's like, think of it as a drill, almost. Similar to a drill, but he is safer. It is your turn, but he can reversal you. So there's always those type of situations that you gotta deal with this matchup. I just feel like Urien has a lot of options against Bison to keep pressuring him once he, because Bison's not good with pressure. He's not good being in a pressure situation, and the fact that this can kind of just easily get in on you, because as a Bison player, you're constantly just trying to pressure your opponent from mid screen. So Urien using that. Using this randomly, you know, when I'm trying to get in on him or something like that, it can just throw me off a little bit. You know, I'm trying to, you know, you can whiff punish me, get in on me. But once I block it, obviously I'm pretty good, but it's very hard to deal with. most of the time when I'm doing block strings, I find that Urians are very they just don't want to be stuck, basically. They don't want to block. So they are tempted to press a lot of buttons, so I would use Inferno a lot, because after the Pierce, like most Urians, they will try to press a button, they'll get hit by the Inferno. So Inferno is a good thing to use against Urien. And Inferno, what else is there to deal with that Urians do? Obviously Urien could just reversal through all this, most of this. But you do want to keep Urien pressure. You don't want to give him any breathing room. You have to force him to like give up meter, basically. The only thing you gotta worry about is V trigger for Urien. Bison doesn't have too much to deal with it. But you can't catch Urians trying to basically hide themselves behind it. You know, they can't just like hide behind it. They can't do that because you can use your EX. That was reverse. The EX works. If they do it in the corner. Oh, yeah, that's something I didn't explain with the birdie matchup. Well, if you... Yeah, okay. You can command grab Urien if he tries to wake up with Egg Reflector. That's another thing I forgot to talk about. Bison, I don't think he could, he can grab him. I don't think you can neutral grab him out of it. But you can command grab Urien out of his Egg Reflector. So it does have weird properties. But most, Urians would do it in the corner. They'll pop Egg Reflector. Just try to, like, you know, they basically feel free to just do stuff in there. Hold on. Oh yeah, you can stomp him. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you can stomp him. Yeah, most of the time when Urien is charging up his attacks. Yeah, yeah. I should have talked about doing that. Yeah. Like when he is spacing you out, you can use that as well if he throws projectile. Like if he's charging, you can just use that. Yeah. You don't have to switch it up. So that kind of eliminates him being able to reverse you after. So yeah, that's a good tool to use. Oh yeah. All right. I mean, you can use your projectile as well if you just want to get in on Urien. And you want to eliminate his fireball game. You can use yours too. It's two hits as well. So think of it as your, like, your V skill. So if you want to save your, like, your V skill for, like, combo, like, you know, purposes, then use this instead. And then... No, you could go for setups after that, basically. So the V skill is very good to use in the combo. It sets up your opponent a lot. So very, very good to use. I'm not sure if he has more combo abilities. All right, let me just test it right now. I never tested it. Let's see if he could. I don't think so. Shit, I held it too long. Get back there. Oh, okay, okay. So I don't know if you get the Psycho Blast though. Kind of sucks. Right. No, stop holding it. But you can set him up, basically. Like I did before, you could like do a cross up after that if he does attempt to quick rise. Oh, hold on. Yeah, if he does attempt to quick rise, you can do that. I'm just getting in the corner. Yeah. trying to see what other stuff you could do. I keep doing that. Yeah, forget it, forget it. I'm pretty sure you guys just do it yourselves in the train room. So if you're using Bison, you can extend combos with your V-skill and set up your opponent after the V-skill with the scissor kicks like I did. You can go for cross-ups and stuff. And you will recover in time after that. So pretty cool setups you can use. A little bit of tech. I was not thinking about showing it, but whatever. It's okay. Alright, so I think I've close range, you have 3 frames, so that kind of helps you out with some of like the close range stuff they put you in. But after his forward medium punch, you have to guess like always. You have to basically block low. I'd rather you block low and react to the overhead than block high and get hit low. Because if you get hit low, then he could keep putting you in like an endless loop with the headbutt, and you have to, you know, basically get out of it. So I'd rather get hit by overhead, unless if he has V-trigger, I'd rather get hit by overhead after a target combo. Because if he hits you with the overhead, he puts you in like a weird situation, or the light shoulder, or the light shoulder as well. Puts you in a very weird situation, very uncomfortable situation you don't want to be in. Alright. So I think that's most of it for... I mean, you could use... Basically, like in my lore video with the pressure, you can use the EX. He can't do anything about it unless if he has, you know, it's mainly just watching Urien's meter. That's all it's mainly about. You're playing a very patient game before you get in. Once you get in, it's more about just mowing down Urien and basically baiting him out to basically... You're basically angering him, the opponent, and getting them frustrated. They can't get out, you know, you're pressuring him. You know, some Urians would attempt to use EX knee just to get out. You know, that's what a lot of Urians do. You could chase them down with the axe. Oh yeah, just make sure you're meeting too. Yeah. Don't be afraid to pressure Urien. Yeah. Alright. I really hope I'm not missing anything that I didn't explain. It's main, yeah, just stay patient. It's not bad to zone out Urien. Yeah, you know, want to get in V-trigger. Bison does excel because he can go through the fireball, Urien's fireball. So, nothing. If you can predict, obviously. You can go through his headbutt as well on block. Like, if he's doing his headbutt and you can predict him headbutting, then, I mean, that works too. Oh, yeah. I'm not sure if you can punish though. But it's pretty good against Urien, unless if he's, crouching. That means he's waiting for you to do that so he can reversal you. But you can obviously grab Bison out of it. Yeah, most of the time if a Bison is going for the teleport on your wake up, well, it depends how close he is teleporting from you. So if he just goes on the other side, you could grab him and whiff punish him basically from his dash. Then you could grab him out of it. Think of it as like a reversal type thing. Alright, that's mainly it, just playing patient, punishing Urien's. You have a 3 frame, so most of Urien's attacks, you could just 3 frame them to death and then get back into it. You know, a lot of times I'll go into that. Like this combo right here is very, very tough because they get hit by a 3 frame. You know, you could check them too, you know, if they're pressing buttons, you could use that as well. You know, they're pressing buttons after that. But scissors do work as well. And watch for jump ins as well. Urien has pretty good jump ins. But basically you can you have to stay solid with Bison. All I can say really in this matchup. And use those zoning tools that I just showed in earlier in the video to get through his zoning. If there's any other questions you have, basically leave it in the comment section below. Like some specific that you're having trouble with, because I know, like, it's not really, because Urien on paper, the matchup looks very different on paper, but in an actual match, it looks very different how it plays out. It's basically just conditioning the Urien to basically force himself to have to get desperate and reversal you. Or you have to, I mean, not reversal, but use his reversal on you. So just staying solid and just knocking him out by using good block strings, checking his zoning out, pressuring him with the Dove's reverse as well. And you can bait out the headbutt with that by going to the other side easily. And once he attempts to try to react, you know, you go to the other side, boom, get the punish. Or you could do the Psycho Axe. Crush counter, heavy punch, heavy inferno into the light blast. Or if you have feed trigger, you know, you can do other stuff with it as well. So, I don't know, I'm trying to end it off with like a cool, like one more thing, one more tech. I mean, I could show the tech again, but I have to make him a quick recovery. And I have to absorb a fireball too. Alright. So I believe you can do a cross-up setup with his scissor kicks. Very low tech, nothing crazy. I'm trying to absorb that. Which one did I do? I forgot. Alright. Just normal recovery. Hopefully this works. Please work. Oh no, I didn't do freaking scissors, goddammit. Try it again. Please be patient while I try to do this tech. Damn it. Alright, relax. Okay. So I have to be charging while I let go, okay. What? What the hell's going on? I thought I absorbed the fireball. That'll happen. Oh, cause I oh wow. Okay. My bad. Try it one more time. If I don't get it this time, I'm done. I actually got one more cool thing before I end the video. Alright. Okay. Yeah, so that's the setup. It's just that he woke up, basically. So you can set up your opponent and meet them. So you go for a cross-up scissor kick. So it's a little tech, nothing crazy, but it's pretty cool though. You can go for a cross-up setup. It basically just throws off your opponent because he might not think that you're safe there or it's an actual setup. So first time seeing it, he'll probably attempt to wake up grab or light punch. So it's pretty good setup to use. All right. Let me off with one more thing. I just want to show, this is what I'm going to do now at the end of all my matchup videos. Basically seeing who's super beats who. So I tried this before and something weird happened basically. So they both basically cancel out each other, both of their supers. Very weird. Alright, no. Oh yeah, I'm probably gonna mess up. Alright, watch this, it's pretty weird. Yeah, so it cancels out. I don't know if it matters who does it first or not. Let me see if I do it first. Oh. Let's test it again. What the? Heck? I guess he can't wake up. I don't know what happened. It's hard to make them the. I'm pretty sure the same thing happens. Yeah. That's kind of weird though. And there's no reason to use it, just block it, unless if you're like about to die and you have no V reversal or anything like that. But it just puts you back in like a zero situation. You both recover at the same time. So from there, it's basically Bison has the light. He has the 3 frames, so he's gonna beat Urien. So Urien has to block and like come up with like a counter very fast. So yeah, I'm ending off with that video. If you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below. If you're struggling with any specific things, and if you like, you know, seeing who super beats who, then you know, tell me in the comment section if you want me to keep doing who super beats who super and basically explain why this super probably beats the other. Like with Birdie and Karen, Birdie beats Karen's super because he has more invincible frames. And there's another thing with Rashid. Rashid's super beats Birdies no matter what. So that's another thing that's kind of... It kind of sucks for me, but at least I got Karen though. So it's okay. I'll take the trade off. Alright. Thanks for watching, guys. I am out. Goodbye.